Ask the gnome.
Don't mind if I do. Welcome back, Brett.
Welcome back, Kim.
Everybody. All right, what are we doing on the third episode here?
Well, since one of the hooks about you that people might be interested in is you are a Knoll, of course, which means those interested in the works of Carlos Castaneda would be interested in your insights, so I thought maybe you could regale us with some things we didn't know about Carlos Castaneda.
Well, first of all, for the listener, viewer, they would have to know about the author, Carlos Castaneda. Who was Carlos Castaneda?
He wrote a series of books that are still very popular about his experiences with a teacher by the name of Don Juan. Is basically, to the average person, it's about a guy who takes a bunch of psychoactive plants and has spiritual experiences. That's like the layman's short version, and he wrote a whole bunch of books about it.
Okay. Of course, there's a lot that I know because he's relating the path of the Nawal, the map of the Nawal, the rule of the Nawal, everything that governs and explains my life and the lineage that has lasted for thousands of years. But your question is, what are the things I didn't know about Carlos?
Well, things that you know about Carlos that, say, somebody who's read a few of the books and might talk about Carlos Castaneda wouldn't know.
Okay, so the first thing to validate that you're in the wall is you have a physical benefactor. That is someone in the Tolteca lineage, in this case from the Don Juan Matus lineage, a Yaqui lineage, that tells you that you are in the wall. So one of the first things I asked my benefactor, Cacharo, when he designated through my luminosity that I was in this lineage and in the wall, I asked them, and what about Carlos Castaneda? Where is he? And his response was, having known Carlos Castaneda, was that Carlos, after he died, is being pursued by the Atlantean Guardians, which are statues on the pyramid in Tula, Hidalgo, in Mexico. They're large stone representations of stalkers and dreamers, but they are chasing Carlos through infinity. So I asked my benefactor, why? And he said, Carlos was obsessed with the old seers. In other words, the way that they did things, they were the first ones to gather the knowledge about seeing and stalking. And because of his indulgence in that assemblage point of the old seers, he is being chased by their knowledge and the visual of stone figures chasing him through infinity has lasted with me to this day.
So for all of his considered maybe a high end of spirituality, he is spending all of infinity being pursued by these, what I would consider, that it's not a happy afterlife, it's forever of...
Yes, and you know, there would be many who do know things about Carlos Castaneda, like questionable his relationship with females in his own court of sorcerers, him not using the Toltec practice of sex dreaming, which would have prevented him from getting in the confusion of regular sex. Maybe all those things contributed, maybe the fact that he's a three-pronged Nawal, which is not a complete Nawal, contributed to him being in this situation. Of course, many of the people out there would say, well, you're in the wall using your dream double. Can you reach Carlos? Can you spend time with him? Can you answer this question? And I have not had that as my interest. My interest was, and this is the second thing that I'll reveal, I asked Cacharo, I said, how do you find out these things about Carlos? And at that point he said something very important to me. He said, I go to the doctora. The doctora is a general overriding name for power plants in the lineage. So when he wanted to find out about Carlos, when he wanted to talk to Don Juan Matus, who was his spirit brother before he passed on, he went to the doctora. So that's my second, I think, wonderful, wonderful moment with my benefactor. The third thing about Carlos that many people probably don't understand, and they should really look at. If they want to criticize him as a spiritual guru, which he never stated he was, I would not go there then. I would look at him as an artist. And I consider his writings to be his Tolteca art. And his writing is some of the most brilliant elocutions of a man and every man going through a spiritual transformation that has ever been written. So you might look at him as one of the greatest artists of the 21st century. And if you're not involved with Tolteca sorcery or spiritual quest, that you would be judgmental about. Number four, the thing that interests me is the fact of sexuality in Carlos's life. And what you don't realize is that every Nawal is intimately connected with sexual energy. And that, as a rocky road for a normal man, is even magnified more for a sorcerer. When I meet a real sorcerer, and my feeling is also with any mystic man, if they haven't begun the exploration of sexuality as part of the whole body alignment, as, let's say, Kundalini or in sex dreaming, then they are not doing the complete work of what I consider heading towards awareness. Number six, I went to go see Carlos Castaneda once. It was the first time that he had come forth to the general public after many years. He was erasing his personal history. And he was giving a talk in Northern California, in the Oakland area. And everyone was anxious to see what Carlos Castaneda looked like. So I went there and then waited when he left the stage to hand him a book that I had done, American Shaman. And this was the moment. I, as a young apprentice at the time, I was going to meet my teacher from the books. Again, Kacharo being the benefactor. A teacher is someone who explains things. A benefactor just validates that you're in the wall and you're doing everything right, for example. Kind of bestows the energetic field of acceptance in the lineage. While Carlos was teaching by doing the right hand information of these are the names, this is the categories of stocking being, whatever. So I was waiting behind the back door, and here comes my teacher, Carlos Castaneda. He's coming out. He's on the platform. He's going down to the white van. There's only a few people between me and him. One of his guards says, yes, just give Carlos the book. I have my eyes on Carlos the whole time. Gone. Van drives off. Now, I have my eye on Carlos the whole time, so I'm going to bring in the term magical pass. Magical pass is when a Nawal is doing an exercise that opens up a portal to dreaming, and those movements called magical passes were passed on to sorcerers forever from Mesoamerica. I consider that one of Carlos's magical passes. He energetically didn't want to do anything after he had put out all that energy speaking to people. However, at that moment, he lost the opportunity for something that he had sought his entire life, and that was to find another Nawal, a completed four-compartment Nawal, in order to pass on his baton. He missed that opportunity. Now, I found out later why, because his health was suffering and he never did another trip up north. He said because and this is number seven, oh yeah, that the dome of protection, the dome of light emanating from the Valley of Mexico did not extend any further than that area of Northern California. So he stayed in the south where the light was conducive to him living longer. I also want to point out that I brought my benefactor to validate that was the case, that the Toltecs got as far as that area of Northern California, and let's say not as far as Canada, and they left their markers. So I'm gonna say that dome of light that he mentioned is something that many people don't know about Carlos. And now I'm at, I think, number nine. Where am I?
Well, who's counting?
People out there are probably familiar that by now that these shows are improvised, so that they may be counting, but And this is number 9 that you probably don't know about Carlos Castaneda and all sorcerers. Spirit, the spirit, our image of that elusive emanation that gives us light and that we speak to and intend to, is not interested in numbers. So you can wish all you want to win the lottery with this sequence of numbers. The spirit doesn't relate to that, doesn't care, is not interested. Which brings me to number 10. Number 10 is something that very few people know about Carlos Castaneda, was the fact that he was an artist, that he started as a sculptor in Peru, and there is one of his works that still remains. It's a sculpted head, kind of, I'm going to say, in a Cubist Giacometti sort of style. He also wanted to be a painter, and this is probably the most interesting thing. He had in his house in Westwood, his final compound, the only thing on the wall were the original paintings of the covers of his books. Now, I say original paintings, they perhaps were prints, but nevertheless, he had those covers framed on his wall. It was such an important aspect of his books because the books were not illustrated, so you only had the covers to give you a feeling of his excursions in the desert with Don Juan Matus. But those covers were so beautifully rendered, and a particular, Giusti is the author that is painted, that's illustrated, that's credited on the covers. But Carlos had a profound impact on guiding the artist into how to visualize the books. And those covers, to this day, are beautiful, fantastic manifestations of the Tolteca tradition of visual artists in contemporary times.
And if you've got a question for my shaman friend over here, write down there in the comments.